Good morning, everyone. This is 287, and to those who keep the Sabbath, have a happy and blessed Sabbath. Now, today I'm going to continue with the study I started a few weeks back, Hierarchy. And this part is about, or entitled, A Virtuous Woman, because I was basically asked a question as to, is a woman's responsibility truly the rearing of the children, and that type of thing. So what I'm going to do is show you what Scripture says. Now, we have to keep in mind that it all comes down to you being right and doing right according to the will of the Heavenly Father, and your man doing right and being in the will of the Heavenly Father. That means that if you're both doing right as individuals, one, you're equally yoked, two, you both understand that you're serving the Father, not each other. Serving each other is a byproduct of doing His will. So if we are right as individuals, we put aside that worldly selfish thinking, the way we view things and responsibilities. So as I go on with this lesson, keep in mind this is about people who are serving the Heavenly Father. We're not looking at it as the world or modern thinking looks at everything as in chauvinistic or that's this or that's that. We're serving the Lord, and in serving the Lord, we can be happy together, and in turn, we raise our children the same way. So anyway, with that being said, let's get started with a virtue. Okay, ladies, I know that a lot of you out there say that you can't find a good man, or you want a good man, and all these things along that line. But you have to understand what a good man is according to the word of the Heavenly Father, so that you don't overlook what a good man is. But a good man or a virtuous man according to Scripture is looking for a good woman or a virtuous woman. These things work together because they're equally yoked. So while you're perceiving that you want a good man and you know what a good man is, you have to also ensure that you are a good woman or a virtuous woman according to Scripture. Someone you can be equally yoked with. And with that being said, I'm going to start off by telling you what Scripture says a good man is. Now, a good man is wise, he is just, he is obedient to the law of the Heavenly Father, that is. He has understanding or discernment. He brings forth good things, and he loves the Father. We're talking about a man who is in the will of the Heavenly Father. And with that, according to Proverbs 12:2, it says, a good man obtaineth favor of the Lord. So a man who's doing right, who's doing the will of the Heavenly Father, obtains his favor. That is a very powerful thing, to be in favor of the Heavenly Father. If you are, that means you receive blessings, you receive protection, you receive guidance, you receive all things that are good. You're pleasing to Him, so you're going to benefit from being pleasing to the Father. You are a blessing, you are a light that He can use to show others. So you're gonna reap those benefits or reap those rewards from being a good steward. Now, Proverbs 12:4 says that a virtuous woman is a crown to her husband. So now we know a good man obtained a favor. So part of that favor is obtaining a woman who is going to be a crown to her husband. Then in Proverbs 18:22 it says, whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth favor of the Lord. So once again, a man who finds a good wife is obtaining favor of the Lord. So we know that the Father is not providing him with any old kind of woman or vice versa. If you're in His favor, He's providing you as someone favorable to Him. So this is what we need to understand about being the right person. We have to be doing what is right, so we're in His favor, so we receive things that are of His favor. Now, Proverbs 31:10 says that, "Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies." Now, if we go back, remember it says that a good woman is a crown to her husband. And then later on it says that her price is far above rubies. So put it together. She is priceless. She is like a crown to her husband. She is something special. This is a virtuous woman, a good woman. Now we understand that being in favor of the Lord has a lot to do with this. And Proverbs 19:14 says that a prudent wife is from the Lord. Now, to be prudent is someone who is careful, practical, wise, sensible, understanding. This is a prudent wife according to Scripture. So you as a woman have to be these things so that you can do the will of the Father. This is part of you being able to be in His favor. Now, 2 Corinthians 2:14 says that this woman understands and says that she would not be a burden to her husband or burdensome to you. And she's concerned about others, her husband, her family, and not herself. Because remember, she is in the will of the Father, so she shouldn't be concerned about herself. She knows she's being taken care of and provided for according to being in His will. So she doesn't have to be concerned or focus on these things. She just focuses on others. 1 Corinthians 10:33, it says that she is concerned of others. Now, let's read Proverbs 31:11, because there's a very important message that needs to be taken from this. 31:11, it reads, it says, "The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil." Now, you have to understand what spoil is. Now, this scripture is saying that this man or this husband, he loves his wife, he trusts her, so he's not concerned about spoil. Spoil is, according to Deuteronomy 20:14 and Joshua 22:8, spoil are other things like other women, cattle, children, gold, silver, brass, iron. So simply it's saying that this good man who loves this virtuous woman or this good woman, he trusts her to a point that he's not concerned about other things. When there's trust lost in a relationship, people's minds and ideas and wants start straying toward other men, other women, other things, other desires, etc. And this is what it's saying. Proverbs 31, 12 through 14 reads, it says, "She will do him good and not evil all the days of his life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant's ships. She bringeth forth food from afar." So now it's illustrating or telling us that she takes care of what? These domestic things for her husband, her family. Now 31:15 says that, "She riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household and a portion to her maidens." So we're being told that a virtuous woman, a good woman, she is taking care of home. She takes care of feeding and all these things. She gets up early and does all these things, and then she even gives a portion to her maidens. So she takes care of home. Romans 12:11 says that she is not lazy, she's spirited, and she is faithful, serving her family. No, it doesn't. It says serving the Lord. She's serving the Lord because the Lord is providing for her. She's doing what the Lord asks of her. This is part of her duties. So she takes care of her duties. Men have duties too. We're not to be caught up in what the world says, because this is the problem today. You have men trying to do what women should be doing, women doing what men should be doing, all these different things in the view of being equal, equality. We have responsibilities that we're each supposed to do according to the Heavenly Father, to be in His will. If done correctly, keep us in harmony with one another, because lines have to be drawn as to who needs to do what. If not, you have a lot of confusion. Proverbs 31:20 reads, it says, "She stretches out her hand to the poor, So she once again, a virtuous woman is about helping others, taking care of things. This is inclusive of the home. Now, Luke 12:42 reads, it says, "And the Lord said, who then is that faithful and wise steward whom his Lord shall make ruler over his household to give him their portion of meat in due season?" This was one of the references from Proverbs 31:15. So it's telling us that this virtuous woman, being a faithful and wise steward, he makes her ruler over her household. But remember, the head of the woman is the husband, and his head is the father. So there's an order still, but he makes her ruler over the household. Domestically, the home is the woman. She rules the house. She takes care of the house. The husband is out doing what he is supposed to do to provide for his family and take care of his family. He shouldn't be running the house and out there doing these things. See, the father has a responsibility for all of us so we can work in harmony with one another. Bottom line, women, worry about your virtue, your goodness. Make sure that you are what the father requires you to be as a virtuous woman. Men have the same thing to worry about. We have to be virtuous men or good men. We all have to love the Lord, be in his will, and do what he requires of us as individuals. He will bring good people together because they will be in his will, and he will provide good things for them. So with that being said, be a virtuous woman, and the father will provide a virtuous or good man for you, and you can come away from struggling with men in your life. Just make sure you're who you need to be. And that's the bottom line. We all individually need to be virtuous in the will, doing his will, obeying his law, and all else will be taken care of. So with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2 Bay 7.